would like to say good morning and welcome you. Good morning. I say good morning and welcome to this edition of Sunday Church. Happy Mother's Day. Amen to all the ladies, all the mothers, whether you're biological or not, if you raise children, participating in the raising of children, we salute you on today and say that we love you. Amen. Like that song says, I'll always love my mama.
Born in the year
2007, but we are blessed and highly favored and thank God that we did have a mother who was beautiful and who loved the Lord and lived a godly example before us. So we are happy for all of the mothers. So if you have a mother and she's alive, she's in the earth on today, if you can't get to her, send her something, cash out her, cook for her, whatever you can do to let mama know that you appreciate her. Amen. For the Bible, and your days may be long upon the earth, but this is the first commandment with promise. So I'm going to encourage you on today. Amen. And just love on mama. Just enjoy being with her and being around her. I already saw people buying crawfish earlier this morning. I said, Lord, it's going to be a lot of crawfish boiling going on this morning, but that's a good thing. Amen. Because anytime you can celebrate the one that brought you into this world and loved you, nurtured you, because our mothers are our first teachers and they're our first cheerleaders. You can do it. Come on, man. Come on. Come on, daughter. Come on. We can do this. You can do this. Come on. Pep yourself up. They take care of us when we're sick. Amen. They do so many things for us. They pray for us. They teach us how to live, how to overcome challenges. So there's many things that they do. And we're grateful to God for them. Amen. So we definitely celebrate all the ladies on today, which is Mother's Day. And to those who may be experiencing grief or loss, you recently lost your mother or you lost your mama a long time ago, but it feels fresh on Mother's Day. You have our empathy as well. And we are praying for you that the Spirit of God ministers to you on today as well. Amen. Because we know these kind of holidays can get very tricky and your emotions can play a lot of different games with your mind. Amen. So just be careful. Amen. Don't do anything that's going to be detrimental, it's going to hurt yourself, anything like that. Amen. As my sister Pastor Lenzia said, don't listen to any songs that you know going to put you all in your feelings or make you all sad and have you feeling emotional, or the last song that you heard when you were with your mama that last time. Don't play those today. Now, there's nothing wrong with those songs if you want to hear them another day, but just don't play those today. Amen. So just do what you can. Amen. To make it through the day for the joy of the Lord. Indeed, it is our strength. Of course, if we could, we pray all our mamas back to the earth, especially on a day like today, just to be with us, to be around, to laugh and to joke and to have a good time with. But that's not the way that it works. So since that's not the way that it works, God gives us tools and he helps us and gives us other people to make up for the difference that is lacking in our lives, since we do not have our mothers here with us physically. But we do still want to let God know that we appreciate him and we appreciate them as well. Amen. So I'm going to tell y'all, like I tell them children where I work, y'all do something for your mamas so you don't have a messed up year. I'm just trying to tell you, because boy, you'll never live it down. You will never live it down. So do something for them today. People all up and down the street where you can purchase something, amen, for, get a card for, put some money in. If you can't do what all you want to do, do what you can. That's what we all encourage people to do here, because at the fellowship, we're very pro-family, we're for the family, we're for what's considered the traditional family, which is the only family, but we'll move on from that, because our vision here that was given by our founding pastor, that we build godly generations with the word of faith. So that's always our objective, is to build up the family, the children and the parents, the husband and the wives, the male and the female within the home unit, because we all need one another. So we begin, of course, with prayer. I greet you this morning in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He is the one that makes us valiant and overcome in every situation, and through him we will have our redemption, we're made whole, and we are cleansed, and we are always victorious in every situation. I'll say it again, you are always victorious in every situation. You don't have to worry about how God feels about your challenge, how he feels about that scenario. You've already come out of it in his eyes. You've already been made victorious through him that loved us all. So we begin, of course, this morning with prayer. Amen. We want to pray for our founding pastor. We believe his body is healed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Gracious Heavenly Father God, thank you on today for your power. We thank you for your healing. We thank you for your wonders. We thank you for your miracles. We thank you, God, for saving us from the pits of burning hell. writing our names most important in the Lamb's Book of Life, thinking that we are saved and being saved. We, God, we appreciate you saving us, reaching down and getting us out of dirty places. You protected us. You've kept us. We're in our right minds. We have clothes that we can wear. We say thank you, Lord God. You are the great I am, the eternal Father, the first and the last, the God who was and is to come. We say thank you, Heavenly Father God, for you ride upon the wind. You sit down upon the circle of the earth. You walk up and down the hot coals here in the earth. God, you dwell in the corners of the north. The clouds and these are the dust of your feet. You speak and a mountain can crumble. You can speak and a man live. You speak and a man dies. We say thank you, Heavenly Father God. Because, God, you are greater than anything we're facing. You're greater than anything we have. You're greater than anything that may be attacking our bodies or our minds or our marriages or relationships or our homes, oh Heavenly Father. God, you are our sword, our shield, and our buckle, our strong tower. We can always run to you and be safe. So we just say thank you this morning, Heavenly Father God, for healing our founding pastor's body this morning, oh Heavenly Father God. We speak hell, healing, and wholeness and completion right now to every fibre of his being in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, for quickening his spirit right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And thank you, God, for infusing him with your Holy Ghost power right now, Heavenly Father God, in his muscles, in his bones, in his tendons, in his sinews, in his cartilage, oh Heavenly Father, his blood vessels, his veins, and his arteries, his nervous system. Everything connects and lines up according to your perfect holy will in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The healing, heating, cooling power of your anointing reaches there right where he is, oh Heavenly Father God, and strengthens his heart and mind through Christ Jesus right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Ancient of Days, the Great I Am, the Everlasting Father, the God who does all things well. We thank you, God, for victory in his body. We thank you for healing. We thank you for wholeness. We thank you for completion in his body. In Jesus the Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Amen. We pray prayer 9 on today, on the 30 days of prayer, praise, and healing, which is victory over the noise and pestilence. We continue to fight this pandemic. The pandemic is not over. It is not over. People are getting shots. Things are starting to open up. People are starting to move around more and more every day. However, it's not over. So we still have to fight and pray. Amen. Believing that our healthcare workers, that their lives are redeemed from destruction, that our lives and the lives of our family and friends are redeemed from destruction as well. And it says, repeat after me if you will, please. Holy Ghost, touch all our youths and teenagers with your fire. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, flow through the Golden Triangle Christian Fellowship Church in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Father, let every enemy believing they have grown beyond the reach of destruction and judgment in this country be punished now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every assignment of witches vanish from my body in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That the power of the shadow of the Almighty God overshadow me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, make my body too hot for every demon of sickness in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Father, be a shield for me in every situation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, hear my cry out of your holy hill. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every ancestral agreement with the spirit of untimely death, break and be destroyed by the blood of our Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every agreement and covenant of hell, fire placed on my family line, be destroyed by the blood of our Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every agreement with the spirit of death on my family lineage, break and be destroyed by the blood of our Lord Jesus. Every evil pronouncement in the kingdom of darkness to control and manipulate my life, I counsel you by fire in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every conspiracy assigned to cage my destiny, be scattered in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every expectation of darkness concerning my health, scatter in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Battles of evil stigma, scatter by fire in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every lie of the enemy manifesting against my destiny, die in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Agenda of corrupt leaders for our land, be nullified with the blood of our Lord Jesus in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You dark stronghold in charge of sickness and disease in our land, fall down and die in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We use the blood of our Lord Jesus to sanitize our land and cleanse it from every witch sponsored sickness and disease in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You dragon power behind this pestilence, we bury you forever by the power and the blood of our Lord Jesus in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Strong man behind this pandemic, we bind and cast you out of our nation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. Those of you just joining us, once again, we welcome you, our members. Happy Mother's Day to you, ladies, who join us on the parking lot, greatly encouraged by our press, by our family, friends, and supporters who join us via social media. We thank God for you. As you're on social media, please share it. Amen. There to your news feed, if you will, please. If you're on the conference call, make sure that your phone is muted. Once again, make sure that your phone is muted if you're on the conference call. Once again, please make sure your phone is muted if you're there on the conference call. We pray next the Rewriting My Family History prayers. These prayers are given to us by our founding pastor on April 26th of this year, 2021. As you repeat these prayers after me, it says, by the mercies of God, the power was assigned to disgrace the works of my hands. You must die today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the secrets of my life, that my parents or anyone else has exposed to my enemies, every secret be erased from my enemy's memory today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All the demons from the place where I was born that are multiplying themselves against me, the arrows of God will kill them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every evil power assigned to rob me, hear the word of the Lord. You will die by fire today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Arise, O God, while I'm praying. Slap my enemies on the cheekbone and let them fall into the pit they've dug for me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every evil power assigned to make me lose where I should gain, your time is up. Die today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The rider and the horse of darkness that have been fighting against me, the Lord of hosts shall break you into pieces. Die today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Satanic devourers operating on my destiny tree, the God of Elijah shall trouble you today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. O God, our Father, by your mercy, arise for the sake of my destiny and show that you are my God indeed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Any power assigned to monitor my star for evil this year, the arrows of sudden death shall locate you today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All my buried virtues, hear the word of the Lord. Today, you shall receive the touch of the resurrection power of the Lord Jesus Christ and come back to me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every wicked elder assigned to bury the glory of my destiny, receive the judgment of death in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You, my destiny, hear the word of the Lord. Arise and shine in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Any power assigned to share the glory of my destiny with a stranger, die now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Holy Spirit. We pray next to prayers. Amen. For correction in our finances. March 8, 2020. If you repeat these prayers after me, please. Thank you so much. Tree of life, be resurrected in my life. 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 Lord Jesus Christ, make the dry places fertile in my finances. Oh Lord, unlock all the padlocks on my treasure chest. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, rebuke the devourer in my finances. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every diversion of my financial blessings away from me. Oh Lord, reverse the diversion and cause the finances to flow to me now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, make the crooked way straight in my finances. Every fight for my finances in the spirit realm be won in my favor. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ground that was iron and sky that was brass in my finances. Turn back the fertile soil and abundant rain. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let my seeds always find good soil. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, defend my finances. In Jesus Christ's name. Lord Jesus Christ, repair every busted gate in my finances. Every lock on my finances that does not have a key. I knock you loose. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every financial bullet be flipped on your head in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, tares among my harvest, burn yourself up in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All treasure chests with my name on them, find me now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, show me as you showed Jacob how to make strong what is weak in my finances. Oh God, for every Goliath that I've killed, cause me to be paid fairly in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Key of David, come to me and unlock every door closed against me in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, I'm more than enough. Bring my finances from the prison to the palace, just as you did for Joseph. Oh God, I honor you with my money, all of my days, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every hangman in my finances, hang yourself in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Spirit of mammon, I am not your dwelling place, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord God, open your good treasures unto me now, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May my treasure and my heart always remain with you, regardless of my financial status. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We thank God for this opportunity to be together on today. Amen. So we thank God, amen, for this day. Once again, happy Mother's Day. See, all of the ladies have a very, very special treat for us on today. Our very own Pastor Lenzia will be ministering the Word of God on today. Amen. Excited about what the Spirit of God has deposited into her spirit. Amen. To share with all of us on today so that we may be uplifted and encouraged on today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're praying her strength. Amen. As she comes and as she ministers the Word freely, and that the Word of God has free course over the airwaves and over these internets and Wi-Fi's and any other way that it may be traveling to reach God's people, and that they have hearts and minds to receive in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Amen? Amen. Receive her at this time. Amen. With all my heart.
You are. Hallelujah. Forever and ever. He's King of Kings and he's Lord of Lords. And every knee is going to have to bow at that name, that sovereign name that heals, that delivers, that saves, that has everything that we need. Hallelujah. It's in that name. Well, good morning this morning. Happy to be here this morning. Happy Mother's Day again to all the mothers out there. If you are a mother, if you've mothered someone else's child, however you flowed in a motherly capacity, happy Mother's Day to you. For the expectant mothers, happy Mother's Day to you as well. For those of you that are grieving the loss of your mother this morning, our heart is there with you. Just know that God cares for you, that he loves you, and that he's able to continue to carry you through this time. Pastor, can you just put on So Easy to Love You, please? Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. God has made my assignment very clear this morning, and I want to be obedient to what he has sent me to do this morning. Hallelujah. He's an awesome, awesome God who's worthy to receive all the glory all by himself. God, we thank you this morning. It's so easy to love you. It's easy to love you. Easy to love you. Because you're wonderful. So easy to love you. So easy to love you. It's easy to love you because you're wonderful. So easy to love you. So easy to love you. So easy to love you. Because you're wonderful. Sing this to him. So easy to love. So easy. It's easy. Your heart, if it's healing in your body, whatever it may be, God is concerned about you. And he said in his word that he sent his word and he healed us. And all you have to do is believe in your heart that God is your healer. Believe in your heart that he's concerned about you. Believe that he can do it. Whatever it is that you need for him to touch, whatever part of your body it is, whatever part of your life it is that you need for him to touch, you just have to believe in your heart that he can do it. And I have confidence in him that he can, and I know that he will. And he said, well, Lenzia, how do you know that? I know it because I've seen him do it so many times in my life. He's healed my heart so many times. He's healed my body so many times. I've seen him do it. So I know that he can, and I know that he will, and I know that he's able. Hallelujah. So right there where you are, just stretch your hand as a sign of agreement. Right there where you are, believing that God can and believing that he will for you. You may have seen him do things for others and you say, well, I don't know if God will do that for me. I'm telling you, yes, he will. And believers, I need you praying in the Holy Spirit right now as we agree together for God to touch and for God to heal and for God to lift his people. God, we thank you right now. We thank you that there is no distance in the Spirit. We thank you right now for your healing power that flows freely in the atmosphere. Father, we thank you right now that you touch right there in that room, oh God. Touch right there in that living room. Touch right there in that kitchen, Lord God. Touch right there in that vehicle, God. Thank you that you're touching minds this morning. Thank you that you're touching hearts this morning. Thank you that you're touching bodies right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I speak to that body right now by the authority of Jesus Christ. I command the blood to flow freely, rushing healing to every extremity in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Body, you function and you flow according to the purpose that God designed you for. Everything has got to come together. Everything has got to move together and synchronize together according to the purpose that God has given you. Even now, pain, I speak to you right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Pain, you must go now. You are not our portion. You don't belong to us. God said that he sent his word and he already healed us. With his stripes, we were already healed, and we received this morning the healing of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, I thank you that your healing power flows now. Touch that body right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Touch that head. Touch those arms. Touch those legs, Lord God. Touch that digestive system. We bless your name right now, God. Thank you that you're cleansing the blood even now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We know the power that's available through the blood of your son, Jesus. And we access that power right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I speak to that body now. Arise in the perfection to which God created and purposed you to function. Right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Arise in power. Arise in peace. Right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Satan, we remind you that you have no power, you have no authority to dwell right now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Loose them and let them go. I speak to that troubled mind now. Thank you, God, that you're bringing peace even now. Thank you, God, for a shield of peace. I hear you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for a shield of peace even now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, we bless you right now for your healing power that is unmatched.
Thank you, Lord.
Nobody can do it but you. Nobody can touch like you can. Nobody can move the way that you can move, oh God. No one can heal the way that you heal. And we thank you right now and we give you glory and we rejoice in you for your healing power that is in operation right now. In every home that's under the sound of my voice. Let your healing powers flow even now, God. Let your healing powers flow and rush your healing power right there where they are, God. We thank you, Lord. We bless your name. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you thanks. We give you praise. For there is none like you. God of wonders, there is none like you. God of miracles, there is none like you. God Almighty, there is none like you. Great, big, mighty God, there is none like you. No one even comes close to you. And we bless your holy and your righteous name, your healing name. You're a strong tower. You're a refuge. You're everything that we need. Thank you for touching your people. Thank you for touching your people now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for healing this morning. We give God glory today for his healing power and for what he has done. Hallelujah. His awesome presence fills your room. Oh, you this morning for your word. Whew. Thank you that you have free course here this morning. We bless your name, God, for there is none like you. We thank you, Lord God. We give you glory, we give you honor. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. God, we thank you right now. If you have your Bibles, whether you have your paper Bible or you have your Bible app, I want to encourage you to go with me to Isaiah 35 and 10. Of course, the power is in the Word of God. I'm thankful for this opportunity to stand this morning and to minister what God has put on my heart. I thank God for my pastors, Pastor R.I. Sampson Jr., and also to our founding pastor, Dr. Reuben I. Sampson Sr. Yes, that's my brother. Yes, that's my daddy. But I honor them as men of God. I honor them as the men of God in my life. And I thank God for them. And I know that it's not a coincidence that I have the task of standing today and sharing the word of God. And of course, you know, Mother's Day, if you watched Destiny Momentum yesterday, if you haven't caught the playback, you can. Of course, Mother's Day is always a little bittersweet time, a little bit. Because while I celebrate the mama that God gave me, I'm also missing her so much, missing her extra. Yeah. On those days where we have an opportunity to show love and to celebrate, we still just want to do something for her. Yeah. We still just want to, you know, get her some flowers, get something that she likes. You know, whenever I go shopping, I still, when I see a size 5.5 or a 6 in a bad shoe, I still think about her. And like, I need to get this. But then I'm like, she don't need no shoes where she is. She does not need these shoes where she is. I don't care how bad they are. They cannot compare to what she has in glory with God. And so today is always bittersweet. And I always have to fight the enemy a little extra on Mother's Day, especially when I have an assignment. And I know that that's not by coincidence. And I thank God that I have the opportunity to stand and that I can stand. Amen. Because if somebody had told me that I could live through that, still love God, still love his people, and still get up and represent for him, I would be like, child, okay, how's that going to work? How's that going to happen? How am I going to make it past that first year?
Yeah.
But you know what? God just kept holding me up. He just kept giving me what I needed. Those years have been passing. I'm still missing her. But God is still God.
Yes,
God is still a present help in the time of trouble. And that don't just mean the trouble that, you know, oh my God, what's going to happen tomorrow? Oh my God, you know, what it is. Oh my God. No, trouble can be things that you don't understand that have happened.
Yes, sir.
That you don't know how you can get up out of by yourself.
Yes, sir.
That can be trouble. And God is a present help. He's never left me alone. Of all of this time, all the times that I've cried, all the times that I've missed her, God has always been right there. And he always gave me somebody that he knows how I am. He knows how you are. Say, God, I need somebody with skin on. Like, I know you here. I can feel you. But, like, I need a hug. Like, you know, I appreciate your embrace, God. But I need you to send me somebody with a hug. And he has never... Like the song said, he has never failed me yet.
Yeah.
And I want to let you know that that same God, your God, that same God can help you where you are. And you may say, well, I don't understand why this happened. I don't understand why this happened to me. Child, I don't either. But listen, I know that he will help you. I know that he will be there for you. Are you at Isaiah 35 and 10? I'm going to pray. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. To proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God. To comfort all that mourn. To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion. To give unto them beauty for ashes. The oil of joy for mourning. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. That they might be called trees of righteousness. The planting of the Lord that he might be glorified. Father, we thank you for this moment. God, we thank you right now for being our God, for being our King, for being our Lord. I thank you right now that you are Lord of all. And God, I thank you that you flow freely through me today, God. Speak through my mouth. God, speak to my heart. Thank you that I can openly share the things that you share with me in our time together. Thank you that I stand boldly this morning as you stand in Daddy. I thank you, God, that I stand, that you stand in me just as you stood in Mama. and you get all the glory, you get all the praise, you get all the credit, you get all the thanks. And I thank you, Father, that your people are drawn to you even the more in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you agree with that prayer, say amen right there where you are. Now, let me tell you all something. Let's go to, are you there in Isaiah 35 and 10? Let's go there first. It says, and the ransomed of the Lord, that's us, shall return and come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Now, you need to highlight that one, because that one gives us our posture. It gives us what we lay hold to. It gives us what we need. This is what we have as a promise. We shall obtain joy and gladness. Judy Jacobs has a song where she turned it around. I like the way she said, they shall obtain gladness and joy, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. I want to let you know this morning, whatever you're dealing with, whatever you're facing this morning, whatever sadness or discouragement that you're facing this morning, I want to let you know that you shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away from you. If you need to add that from me on the end, if you need to say, I shall obtain gladness and joy, I shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away from me. Yes. If you need to put your name in there, if you need to put your pronoun in there, do what you got to do so that you can possess what the scripture, what the word of God has promised us. No matter how sad I feel, no matter how discouraged I feel, no matter how you may feel, you shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Now, I want to tell y'all, the enemy knows no new tricks. No, Pastor, none. He is not original at all. He knows none. He's copycat. He knows no new tricks. He's doing the same thing over and over and over again. That's all he knows to do. Yes. And so this morning, when I woke up and I was getting all my things together, Pastor, and I was trying to put a little makeup on, you know, represent a little bit, that, you know, mama didn't play that, you know, go out there, you know, pull yourself together, get yourself together to go out and greet people. But listen, I started getting my things together, and so I went to look into my iPad, I went to look into my phone also. You all, what I've been working on, Pastor, all of that, all my notes, all my everything, you can see the note, but when you tap on it, blank, nothing there. I tried to airdrop it to my other two iPads.
Yeah.
It airdropped, accepted, blank. I said, oh, this is what we're doing today. Yeah. Okay. And I'm like, you know, the devil, he always forgets. I'm Ruben and Linda's girl.
Oh,
we know all about Plan B. We know all about fighting the devil. I said, child, you done forgot. I got a notepad on my nightstand. We can go old school if we need to. I can bust out the steno notepad if I need to.
Yes, sir. Yes.
What are you talking about, Lindsay? I'm talking about organizing to fight the devil.
Yes.
I couldn't just go into a corner and text my brother and say, Pastor, I can't find none of my notes. I don't know what I'm going to do. I couldn't come up here and give that excuse how people give before they get ready to sing and they know their voice a mess. Well, I want y'all to just pray for me and bear with me this morning. I had a little cold this weekend. You know, I'm going to do my best and I'm going to sing this the best that I can, but y'all pray for me. In my family, we were raised, look, if you own the sing, get up, pray before you get up, ask the Lord to help you, sing and sit down. Don't be getting up giving all them disclaimers and all of that. And half the time, they ain't really been sick no way. They just, you just want a little attention.
Amen.
Okay. We're not going to go into that today, Pastor. But organize to fight the devil. I could have just said, you know what? It's Mother's Day. I'm already not feeling this no way because I miss my mama. I'm mad. I don't want to be bothered. And this is a sign that I don't need to do this today. This is a sign I don't need to preach this. The devil is a lie. You tell me how God has been speaking to me and telling me what to say. Then the page goes blank. And then all of a sudden, I got to say, well, maybe I wasn't supposed to say that.
Yeah.
I know you lying. Yeah. Oh, no, ma'am. No, sir. God has put this word on my heart to share, and I'm going to share it.
Yes, yes,
and that whether it was from a phone, an iPad, a notepad, post-it notes, whatever it was, we organize to fight the devil, and you don't allow the enemy to push you.
Yes.
You have something you have to do. Baby, push.
Yes.
Do what you got to do. Don't let the enemy discourage you that way. Hmm. And then, Pastor, the Lord told me what to do.
Wow.
He said, it's blank. Copy it anyway.
Yeah.
And airdrop it.
Wow.
And when I copied it and airdropped it, then all the stuff popped up. I said, well, all right, Jesus, talk to me. But the enemy was trying it. I'm like, no, you lying. We're not doing this today. Mm-hmm. I'm Linda's girl.
Yes, you are.
We've been fighting you a long time. And we're not tired yet.
Yes,
glory to God.
Glory,
so you shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. That's according to Isaiah 35 and 10. Now, we hear a lot of things in church. I've heard a lot of things in church growing up as a little girl. There are some things, you can finish the sentence. You know, if you've been in church, they even have a game around this where they give you a phrase that starts and you finish the phrase. And if you've been in church any amount of time, you know what to say. You know what comes next, right? So if somebody gets up and says, God is good, you say all the time, and they say all the time, God is good. Like, we just know that from being in church. It's some stuff that we just know. But the sad part is, the same is to be said of some scripture. There are some things that people have heard openly said. They can finish the sentence, but they don't even know if that's really in the book.
Oh.
Don't even know if it's really in the Bible. But I can finish the sentence, though.
Yeah.
That's how somebody can say death and life is in the power of my hand. Just know that's not what the book say. That's not in the Bible. You're not gonna find that nowhere. But what Pastor said, if you find it, I'll eat it. I ain't hungry. It's not in there. But there are plenty of people that can finish the sentences and know the cliches and have heard pieces and parts of scriptures that they can put together and think that they know the promises of God and the word of God. You can't get it unless you get into it.
Yes.
What I learned in Vacation Bible School as a little girl, I need to get into the word of God to make sure what I heard and what I remember is what's really in there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because the power is not in what you remember and what you heard. It's about what's really in your heart.
Amen.
If you hear Pastor, he says that he's never gotten on us about memorizing verses.
Yeah.
Any verses that we remember as children, it was strictly for like Vacation Bible School, program, if it was a part of your Easter speech, things like that. Okay? He never pushed us. Mama didn't either. Never pushed us to memorize scripture. But they taught us to live it. And they taught us to get into the word of God and to read the word of God for ourselves. You know, we had incidents where we were with our grandpa, and he liked to show us off, you know, to his family because we were smart and, you know, we knew the books of the Bible and we knew some verses, and he liked to get us in front of people and tell us, no, say this, do that. And that was so far removed from how our parents did things.
Right.
Sometimes we look at each other like, now we sick of this, now look. This ain't what the scripture is for. This is not, listen, that is not what we memorize scripture for, is to be putting on no show.
Amen.
For your family members. I know you proud of your grandbabies and everything, but we're not using this. We don't do this.
Amen.
Whew. But you have to know the scripture for yourself, not to memorize in front of other, and to say stuff in front of other people and to let other people know how much you know. Do you know enough for it to hold you on your day-to-day living?
Yes.
Okay.
Amen.
This is a popular one that we know. Psalm 30 and 5 encourages us that joy comes in the morning. A weeping may endure for a night.
Right.
But joy comes in the morning. We know that one. If you've been in the church any amount of time, you know that. And that's also a scripture that people reference a lot. For, you know, going through trouble or loss of a loved one. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And, oh, we are always so excited when the joy comes.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, you know, you make it all through the night.
Yeah.
You might toss and turn. You might have insomnia. You might be up all night. You might be up trying to figure it out and you can't. You might be up troubled all night, but you know that the morning is coming.
Yeah.
And when that morning comes, it's a relief.
Amen.
A change in your situation when you're dealing with something, it's a relief. But listen, I told Daddy yesterday, I said, this is what I'm zeroing in on. Is that the word talks about when joy comes.
Yeah.
But when does it go?
Oh.
When at what point does it go? During our day, at what point is it that joy is all of a sudden? How easily do we let go of our joy? How fast, like what situations come in and we lose our joy just like that? Have you ever been in a really, really good mood?
Yeah.
I mean, a good mood. You listen to all your favorite songs. You're smiling and dancing. You're feeling good.
Yeah.
You know, everything is going your way. And then one thing can happen. One person can say one thing and your joy just goes poof. You in a bad mood. You're acting ugly with everybody. You don't want to be bothered. That joy came.
Yeah.
But then it went.
Yes.
How easily do we let our joy go?
Mm.
Sometimes it feels like the joy and the gladness. Sometimes it feels like a balloon that we're trying to hold on to.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a child holding on to a balloon that they're playing with in a high ceiling room? And somebody can see if they let go of it. Somebody can see it going up, going away from the child, out of their reach. And any adult with any kind of compassion, what are you going to do? You're going to take it and grab it and give it back to them. And I want to tell you today, as believers, we still have a responsibility. When you see your brother or your sister, when you see them letting go of their joy, if it's within your grasp, if it's within your reach, why don't you just reach up and give it back to them? Instead of just watching it. Oh, there it went. One of the most irritating things I see is an adult see a child, can help them, and just stand and look at them and watch it float. Now, you see this thing, and you tall enough where you could have grabbed it 3 or 4 times,
yeah,
but you just gonna let it. You see your brother or your sister struggling.
Yeah.
You see them having a hard time. You know something that you can do to help them. You know something that you can do to help them with their joy. And you just stand there and just watch it just, because that ain't got nothing to do with me.
Mm.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
That's your brother. That's your sister. Yes, it does.
Yeah.
It's too many people backing off and saying that don't have nothing to do with me. How are we all connected? How are we all God's children? How are we a part of God's body?
Yeah.
But that ain't got nothing to do with me. I can help, but that ain't got nothing to do with me. God told me what to do, but that ain't got nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
Yes, it does.
Yes, it does.
If you see them letting go of their joy,
mm,
if you see them discouraged, why not encourage them? Why not give them a word of encouragement? Why not give them a word of peace that's going to help to push them and to help them to get through their day?
Mm.
That's a lie that the enemy has fed to a lot of believers to keep them from being obedient. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Are you sure?
Mm.
Are you sure it don't have nothing to do with you?
Yeah.
Because guess what? What we do is a seed. So if I refuse to be obedient, that's disobedient, no matter how you make it, cute, dress it up, however you want to say it, whatever you want to call it. That's a seed that I'm planting. So it does have something to do with me. If I'm missing an opportunity to be a blessing, if I'm missing an opportunity to encourage, if I'm missing an opportunity to be salt and light in the earth, that does have something to do with me.
Amen.
Because I just made it have something to do with me. When I refuse to be who God has called me to be, it has something to do with me.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, it does. But the enemy will tell you, oh, that don't have nothing to do with you. Don't worry about that. They grown. They'll figure it out. How many people are having to figure things out this morning?
Mm.
Because believers are sitting on their behinds being disobedient.
Yeah, amen.
nothing to do with you. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. And how would you feel if someone can help you? You know, we pray prayers for people to help us.
Yeah.
And God is raising up people to help us.
Yeah.
But do you know he's raising you up too?
Amen. That's real.
When my mother went home to be with the Lord, I said, now listen, God, I don't know how you going to work this. Because she was in her early 50s. Okay? And how old was I, Pastor? Let's see, I wasn't even 30 yet. I wasn't 30 yet then. And I'm like, okay, excuse me. You know, I'd already got married the first time. She seen me graduate. She hadn't seen me graduate from college yet. But I'm thinking, I still got all these other milestones. And you want me to do this without my mama?
Wow.
Like, what? And there were other women that tried to attach themselves to me. Child, don't get me started. But there were other people that tried to attach themselves to me,
yeah,
to try to fill that space. But boom, that space is blocked off.
Yeah.
That's done with. That's over with. That's done. There will never be another hurt. And I realized that. And I kept saying, well, God, with everything that I felt like I needed from her, being a younger woman,
yeah,
what am I supposed to do? And time kept passing. And I kept hitting God with that question.
Yeah.
And I got to a point and God said, well, now it's time for you to be that to other young women.
Wow.
Now it's time. They're looking for that. And you have it in you. It's your turn to do that.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
sometimes as we get older, we feel like, well, I'm still young. I'm still young. We still having birthdays, but I'm still young a little bit. I don't feel like I can assume that role. And God's like, when do you think you're going to hit that point?
Oh.
When is it going to happen? So a lot of the things that we're looking for, and a lot of the things that we feel like from your mom going home to be with the Lord, you feel like, well, what about this and what about that? And I need this and I need that. How about you help the people that need this and that? Okay. So I've got to hold on to my joy that I have in Christ as tightly as I can. Because there are going to be things that come to try to disrupt the joy that I have. That's a song the old saints used to sing. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. The older I get, the more I understand it. The world cannot give you the joy that Christ brings. The joy that even going through a tumultuous situation, you can still smile because you know that God is on your side. You might not know how you're coming out. You might not know how he's going to do it. You might not know who he's going to use. But there is a joy in knowing that he's with you.
Yes,
glory to God.
Glory.
So where did I put my joy? And one of the most annoying things when you lose something is to tell somebody you lost something. And they ask you, well, where was the last place you had it? Now, if I knew where I had it last, don't you think I would have went and checked there?
Yeah.
But thank you so much for that, Captain Obvious. Where'd you have it last? And usually you just look at them for a minute and let the moment pass because you can't believe they had the audacity to ask you that question because it kind of insults your intelligence a little bit. And then you feel like it insults their own intelligence a little bit because why are you asking me that? Because obviously, if I knew where I had it last, I would have checked there.
Correct.
But where did you put your joy last?
Mm.
I'm annoying you this morning. Where did you put your joy last? Where did you last see it? Where was the last place you saw it? He said, well, the last time I saw it was when I spent time with God that day. And then I got some bad news and I got mad at him. And stuff just kind of shifted after that. Do you know that your joy is still waiting on you in that same place you left it?
Wow.
Did you know that? When you misplace your remote control, doesn't say, oh, she lost me. Let me get up and walk somewhere else. And let's play a game. let's play a game since she got to find me. Let's play a game. It's going to be right where you left it.
Yep.
And guess what? Your joy is right where you left it. God is, he's there with you, but you feel like, well, I feel like God moved. God ain't moved.
Talk today.
We did.
Yeah.
God says, I'm faithful. I'm steadfast. You can count on me. I'm going to be who I say I am. I don't change. That God says those things.
Yes.
People say, well, I feel like God changed his mind. He what? He said he doesn't change. Dealing with people and trying to govern yourself accordingly with dealing with God gets us in trouble. Yes. Because God doesn't flow like people. People can know something on you and change. God knows what you did and says, you can repent and I can throw that behind my back. I can hide it.
Yeah.
I can put it in the sea of forgetfulness.
Yeah.
And he ain't going and grabbing stuff when he get mad at you. Hold on, let me go on back to the sea of forgetfulness. Let me go ahead and grab this real quick, throw this up in your face. God doesn't operate like that. So your joy is exactly where you left it. In your prayer time, when you had joy, when you used to talk to God in your vehicle, that joy that you felt is still right there. And the enemy always wants to make us feel like we're so far away from what God has for us. He always wants to make us feel like the things that we have and the way that God takes care of us and how he nurtures us and how he loves us. He always wants to make us feel like we're so far away.
Yeah.
And it's always right there. Right there where you left it. Go back and get your joy. Go back and get it. Look at Psalm 28 and verse 7. Glory to God. It says, the Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song will I praise him. Did you get it? Did you catch that? The Lord is my strength when you're feeling weak.
Yes.
And my shield against whatever it is. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoiceth, and with my song will I praise him. Glory to God. See, these are good scriptures to pray. These are good scriptures to confess over yourself. Speaking about you. This is where I am. This is what I'm supposed to be doing. This is my response. This is my posture.
Yeah.
From the word of God. Look at Hebrews 12. Glory to God. Hebrews 12 verses 1 and 2. It says, wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. He knew that there was a joy that was set before him. That's how he was able to endure everything that he went through. In life, we feel like, oh, I've gone through this, I've gone through that. I've been here, I've been there, went through this. Dealt with this trouble, came out of this, dealt with this calamity, dealt with this health challenge, dealt with this health issue. And guess what? We've got joy that is set before us, that we have a home, that this is not our home. Listen, the world is not our home. I know it's a lot of things that you can buy. It's a lot of luxurious things that you can get, a lot of luxurious lifestyles that you can live, but this is not our home. Heaven is our home. We have joy that is set before us that we have to finish our course.
Yeah.
And that's my prayer every day. As much as I miss mama, I say, God, help me to finish the work that you sent me here to do. She did her part. She completed her assignment. And people say, well, she could have done this, she could have done that. Or she had lived longer, she could have made an even bigger impact. She did what she was sent here to do. She completed her assignment. So on Mother's Day, I can say, yes, I miss her. Yes, I wish she was still here. But guess what? I'm still here and I have an assignment to complete.
Yeah.
I have joy that is set before me that I must continue to stay focused in this race to complete the assignment that God has put me here for. And I want to tell you the same thing. You have been put on this earth for a purpose. You have been put here for a reason. And I don't mean this other crap people come up with, you know, stuff. I believe I'm here, but no. The reason that God put you here, the purpose that was in you before you were ever formed in your mother's womb, that purpose that you are here for. And you've got joy that is set before you. You've got a reason to keep going. Because heaven is our home.
Yes, it is.
Because heaven is where we want to be. I want to hear him say, well done. I want to see Jesus.
Yeah.
And I want to go with him. I want to be with him. He prepared a place just for us.
Yeah.
And I want to go where he is.
Yeah.
I want to enjoy what he has prepared. And you say, well, I just feel so discouraged down here. And I want to tell you, your joy is where you left it. You can still go and get your joy. You can still go and grab your joy. It's still there for you. We read in the word of God that says, we shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and signs shall flee away. So in those moments where you feel in some kind of way, in those moments where you feel like I don't have the peace that I want to have,
Yeah. You
can confess this over yourself and say, I shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and signs shall flee away from me. This other feeling that I have shall flee away from me.
Yeah.
This discouragement that I feel shall flee away. This discouragement, this disruption that I feel,
Yeah. Shall
flee away. And one thing that I learned while Mama fought her whole fight when she was there at St. Elizabeth Hospital, I watched her fight. I watched her disposition. I watched her with tubes in her
Yeah. Fight
to pray in the Holy Ghost. I don't know what all that little lady prayed, but I know that she prayed. And I watched her, one of the last times I heard her speak, it may have been the last time, Pastor, I heard her speak, she gave some very specific instructions. And one thing about Mama, when she gave the instructions, you gonna carry out what she asked you to do.
Yeah.
You gonna do that. You're gonna do that. And she gave those instructions. And I just sat in awe. And I said, look at this woman. In ICU, in this hospital bed. She's already a little woman because she wasn't no more than 5 feet tall, y'all. Little lady.
Yeah.
She was shaped, but she was still little. But I said, look at this. This little woman in this hospital bed. Her body is weak.
Yeah.
We didn't know what all was going on. But she still spoke with authority. And she still set things in order.
Mm.
That's a powerful woman.
Yeah.
And I watched that. Some people say, oh, she was giving up. No, no. That moment was not an awe moment. That moment showed me that even in adversity, even in sickness, she still knew who she was in Christ. And she still knew that she could speak with authority, and she still had to share from her heart and set things in order so that things wouldn't fall apart. Because at that time, everything was shifting. Everything was changing at that time. As much as we wanted to hold on to normalcy as much as we could, from that time on, everything shifted.
Yeah.
And she could have just said, I'm sick, I'm in this bed, I'm tired, y'all figure it out.
Yeah.
Y'all figure it out. Whatever it's going to be, y'all figure it out. But she sat there and she set the order. And gave us instructions on what to do. And I did what she told me to do. I did what she told me to do. But do you know this morning that God has given you instructions? He's given me instructions.
Yeah.
That he left with us. That we have to fulfill.
Mm.
That we must execute. That we must get done.
Yes, yes.
Discouragement, pain, whatever it is, you still got to do what God has put you here to do.
Amen.
He said, but I don't know what I did with my joy. I don't know what I did with my peace.
Mm.
Go right back to where you left it.
Yeah.
You left it in God. Where you left it. And just say, God, I'm back. I'm here. I need you. I can't do this without you.
Yes.
See, sometimes we get into ourselves and we say, you know, I'm going to figure this out. I'm working out. I'm grown. I'm going to figure this out. It's going to be okay. It's going to be all right. I'm working. And God is right there. Just go and tell him, God, I need you.
Yes, yes.
I need your help. And what is he going to do? He's going to help you.
Yes, he will.
Every time. He's going to help you. The enemy wants you to think that he's going to push you away, that he's going to, you know, shoo you off. But listen, no. No, ma'am. No, sir. God is there with arms open wide to pardon us and to embrace us and to love on us. And he's going to be some correcting doing now because he's our Father. Who he loves, he corrects.
Yeah.
But he loves you. And he cares for you. And he cares for your heart. So he said, where did I put it? Your joy is right there where you left it. It's right there. It's right there. And we have to help each other to hold on to it. You said, well, I don't really know how to help them. Yes, you do. Because God has spoken to you on what to do. You just ignoring it because you don't want to be bothered. God has spoken that to you. And I hear you, Lord. A lot of things that you are waiting to be unlocked, a lot of things that haven't happened, is because you haven't visited that opportunity for obedience. Some things that have been tied up is because you crossed out of that point of that opportunity for obedience. Somebody need to pray this morning, God, take me back to that opportunity for obedience. He said, well, stuff been held up. Yeah, some of that's being held up this morning because you still haven't gone back to that opportunity of obedience. See, sometimes an opportunity can feel like a burden when obedience is involved. But if you look at it as an opportunity, the Lord can bless you. It's an opportunity. It's not a burden. It's an opportunity to be obedient. I have an opportunity to do what God says do. I have an opportunity to be a blessing. Will you go back and revisit that opportunity of obedience? Because your joy might be in there.
Yeah.
Your joy might be in that opportunity of obedience.
Mm.
Mm. Glory to God. God, help us this morning.
Help us, Lord.
Help us this morning. Your joy may be right there where you left it at that opportunity of obedience.
Mm.
You just didn't want to do it. You didn't want to. You felt like you weren't ready. You made every excuse that you possibly could. You didn't want to be bothered. Whatever it was, it's right there at that opportunity of obedience. An opportunity, not a burden. An opportunity.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Glory,
and God has you watching this right now because he wants you to access and obtain joy and gladness. And he wants sorrow and sighing to flee from us. That's not his will. That's not his will. Sorrow and sighing, that's not his will. He wants us to obtain joy and gladness. And that's yours this morning. Father, we thank you right now for being such a faithful God. We thank you right now for being a present help in the time of trouble. God, I thank you that you take us back to those opportunities of obedience. God, I thank you that you make us willing in the day of your power. God, I thank you right now for willing hearts. Thank you, Lord God, for immediate obedience in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank you, Lord God, for that joy and the gladness that you promised us. Thank you that you lift up bowed down heads even now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord God, for healing your people. Thank you for soothing them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, we thank you for your power that's available. Thank you for your joy that's available. And we bless your name and we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor and we give you all the thanks in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you right now for your healing power that has flowed. Thank you, Lord God. We bless your name, for there is none like you. We glorify you and we honor you. We bless your name, oh God. Now listen, and you listen and you say, well, what about the joy you were talking about? You can only have that through Christ. So, well, how do I get that? You have to accept him into your heart. In Romans 3 and 23, it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That's all of us. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. All you have to do is believe. It's a free gift. Salvation is a free gift. It's not anything that you have to pay for. It's not anything that you have to go ask somebody that you know for. It's not something you have to go and get from somewhere. It's right there available to you, right there where you are right now. You say, well, how can I get it? All you have to do is believe in your heart and confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and you shall be saved. I want all of us to pray this prayer together right there where you are. Pray it out loud. Dear God, I know without Jesus I'm lost. I believe your word that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. I now invite you into my life and receive you by faith as my Lord and Savior. I'm sorry for my sins, and I thank you for your forgiveness. Jesus, you are my Lord. I am now a creature, a new creature in Christ, and a child of God. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer with us, you are saved. You say, is it that simple? Yes, it's really that simple. Just confess with your mouth, believe in your heart. That's it. That, you are saved right now, and heaven is rejoicing because your soul has been added to the kingdom of God, and you know that heaven is your home. So heaven is rejoicing. We're rejoicing. We want to encourage you to join us right here. You can catch us on Facebook or on YouTube. We're here on Facebook Wednesdays for Word Wednesday, 6:30 p.m. We're here praying and warring, and then we get the Word of God. Sunday mornings, we're here, 8:30 a.m., praying and warring, and we get the Word of God. We praise and worship God. And listen, that's going to help you to grow your inner man and to get stronger and to get stronger and become who God has called you to be. So I want to encourage you to be here with us. For those of you that have joined, members of the fellowship, we appreciate you so much. Those who joined us on Facebook Live, we appreciate you and love you so much. We believe you're going to have a good week this week. You can join us again right here on Wednesday night, 6:30 p.m. for Word Wednesday. We love you, and we'll see you then.